online world is toxic, it's hateful, it's vicious, and often so vicious that people, women in particular, find themselves at the receiving end of ugly threats. The Congress's Priyanka Chaturvedi was horrified last week when one Twitter handle threatened her teenage daughter with rape. Today, that man was arrested. Priyanka had filed a police case, and after the intervention of the Union Home Minister, we saw the police acting very quickly. The man who has been arrested is Girish Maheshwari. He was arrested from Ahmedabad. Well, there is, meanwhile, the government also seriously being worried at the moment on how to fight fake news on social media. Rumours and fake videos on WhatsApp have led to a series of lynchings in India this year. In fact, there have been 18 people who have been lynched since the 20th of May. Just on child kidnapping rumours alone. Now, WhatsApp has told the government that it's going to have some new features that it will introduce soon in order to be able to help with this problem. But the question is it going to be easier said than done?
Under fire after a spate of lynchings, WhatsApp is making key changes to try and stop the spread of fake news. The changes are in group chats, so that every user can identify what's genuine and what's fake. WhatsApp has over 200 million users in India, of which 150 million users are on groups. Recently, a new setting was introduced that enables administrators to decide who gets to send messages within individual groups. The idea is to weed out inflammatory messages, but the onus is on the admin. What if the admin shares the fake news like many fake news clips want users to do?
कृपया ध्यान दें, ये तीन लोग अगर आपके घर के आसपास या स्कूल के आसपास या किसी भी जगह पर दिखे, तो आप बिना देरी किए तुरंत पुलिस को कॉल करें। ये लोग बच्चे का अपहरण करते हैं। आप अधिक से अधिक लोगों को पोस्ट भेजें। ऐसे करके आप किसी के बच्चे का अपहरण होने से रोक सकते हैं। नीचे तस्वीर भेजी जा रही है। ये भारत के किसी भी कोने पर हो सकते हैं। कृपया इस पोस्ट को ज्यादा से ज्यादा शेयर करें। धन्यवाद।
Another feature currently in works in India is to flag a forwarded message as compared to a user-composed one. WhatsApp is testing a feature in India to identify a message as forwarded. Critically, it also said they are using machine learning to identify accounts sending a high volume of messages faster than any human could to improve their ability to stop unwanted automated messages. The Facebook-owned company says it will work with leading academic experts in India to learn more about the spread of misinformation to help improve WhatsApp. WhatsApp is not willing to confirm when they will roll these changes out, but they say it will be soon. And users will need to update the app and perhaps exercise some common sense with inflammatory messages. Bureau Report, NDTV.
Well, joining us tonight on the program, we have the Congress's Priyanka Chaturvedi joining us from Mumbai tonight. Also with us here in the studio, Nikhil Pawar, the founder of Medianama, who has been writing extensively on these issues. Apar Gupta is a lawyer who deals particularly with issues related to cyber issues. Vineet Goenka used to be with the BJP's IT cell. He was the national co-convener with them at one time. And Jensi Jacob is the managing editor of Boom Live, which is a fact-checking site and has been doing some terrific work in busting fake news, along with other sites like Alt News, etc. But first, Priyanka, let's talk to you about, you know, this particular case that unfortunately must have really shaken you and your family. Finally, you know, we've seen that this man was arrested today, and I'm sure you're breathing a sigh of relief.
Absolutely, the shock that I received when I saw this kind of a tweet also depressed me, that our level of discourse has fallen to levels where they do not even spare our young children, children who are not even involved in the political narrative of the society right now. They do not even know that their mother is a part of a political dispensation where she speaks on behalf of a political ideology. So this was something which really impacted me, and I thought we need to take this head on, and we need to expose the faceless, nameless handle that was issuing these kind of violent threats directed not just at me but at my daughter too. And that is how it led me to file an FIR, and I'm glad that the police, the Mumbai police and the Delhi police, took this on a priority, understood the seriousness of the threat, and ensured that the accused was nabbed. And now I'm just hoping that the entire investigation will take place. The entire court case will be dealt with severely as well, and he is punished and gets the punishment that he duly deserves.
Priyanka, do you know anything about this man, who he is? And I'm not speculating about it. I know there's a lot of stuff that has circulated on our favorite place, that is Twitter. But none of this has been verified yet. So have the police told you anything about who he is, what his background is, why he did this?
To be very honest, I did not seek an opinion from or want to understand from the police as to what where he comes from or what ideology he belongs to, or has he been working with any particular organization. But his social media profile very categorically states which political party he belongs to, and it doesn't surprise me, because it is this very political party which happens to be in power, continues to maintain a studious silence over these kind of vile abuses and threats directed at women. Unfortunately, their own leader had to face the same kind of trolling that we women have been facing all along, and we've been making this an issue, but it has been totally ignored by the government agencies. So I'm just hoping whoever it is, wherever he comes from, sends a strong message that this kind of abuse will not be tolerated anymore, and we are willing to fight them head on.
But you know, Priyanka, let's face it. I think in your case, and I'm going to open this to the panel as well now, in your case, you know, it's a high profile case. It was reported, it was written about, the Home Minister intervened, and you saw really quick police action. There are people who are facing these kind of threats online, all the time. And therefore, there needs to be a stronger message that needs to be sent across the board.
Absolutely. I'm in total agreement with what you have to say, because this became a point of discussion and the focus point for many debates on social media and trolling, and it came immediately after what Mrs. Sushma Swaraj went through and what Governor Swaraj went through. It got more discussion space. However, I believe the more we discuss and the more we engage on this critical issue will create more awareness in the minds of the people, and the more it is debated will also ensure that people take this up seriously and will not allow abuse to become the norm and the way discourse is being managed in the times we live in. And we have seen how this fake news and the fake industry that prevails right now in the society has led to hate crimes and mob lynching.
And we're going to talk about that.
So that also will be a point of discussion and focus.
We're going to talk about that. Apar, let me ask you about the importance of this arrest. The fact that, here is a person. We hear about people threatening people on Twitter. We hear about accounts being suspended, accounts being locked from time to time. But here is an arrest, a real arrest. The guy was produced in court, all of that. Yeah. Do you think it does send out a message that if law enforcement wants to act, it can, and it can go after you?
Yeah, certainly. Firstly, Nidhi, I'd like to express and join a cause with Priyanka here. I'm deeply sorry this happened. She had to go through this. But this is an experience many women are going through, many people from minority groups, people who are stereotyped are going through on a daily basis, especially when they voice political opinions. Now, while you pointed out that technical measures of blocking, filtering are available to people online, the law and order policing functions of the state are primarily what need to be attracted in these cases. Police needs to put out information periodically, what action it's doing, and it needs to file charge sheets expeditiously. We do not, and I guess a lot of people know this, it is not as if India has a substantive dearth of laws today. It is a problem of implementation, of sensitization, and of the policing function to keep step with technology. And I hope we go to old-fashioned methods a bit, we step back a bit from the technological solutions and place responsibility for governance on government. And its primary duty is to ensure our safety.
Which is the point I made, Nikhil, that here, Home Minister intervened, high-profile case, etc. It's not going to happen on a daily basis. So what is needed then to really tackle online crime? This is a crime. It's a threat. How do you tackle it seriously?
No, I think the first step is that you need to be able to identify the individual who is threatening, and which is what they've done in this case. It means that if police gets to work, they'll be able to figure out who it is. it's very easy to blame the platforms for these things. And yes, platforms also need to evolve with time with reporting mechanisms, because when they start with a few hundred thousand users. With millions of users, the behavior changes. And so they need to evolve. They need to allow people more protection in terms of blocking, reporting. They need to work with law enforcement. So there's a whole bunch of things that needs to be done, even from a user education perspective. Well, I don't know what else can be done apart from speedy justice in some of these cases.
Yeah.
But we also have to be conscious of the fact that, you know, it's a type of speech that's important to be judged on over here. Someone who's threatening violence is very different from someone who is criticizing.
Obviously, there is a difference. That's why I said it's a crime.
And I think that, so you know, crimes that are happening offline, they need to be treated the same way as crimes that are happening online.
Vineet Goenka, your first thoughts on this arrest today and the message it sends. And is this guy a member of the BJP, as some say his social media profile claims? Do you know?
Well, on two things. I think 2 days back when we were in a debate, I also requested her to go to the police, and I said to her that time that I have faith in police, and police did the same thing. And police does this with everybody, irrespective of the profile with the person carries or irrespective of the instructions which comes from this. I have seen in various cases. So police do not work selectively, A. B, rightly what Nikhil said, this should be done for online cases as well as offline cases. Now, one case I would like to share with you, a minority girl in IT cell of Congress. She complained, and Devaji just put it off, saying, you know, the tormentor was not doing it. So I think there should be a police case, there should be an investigation on that, whether the tormentor really harassed that minority girl who was there in the IT cell of Congress. And if it was there, he should be booked. If it's, the case is a false complaint, then the girl should be booked. But this should be discussed, and this should be done like the way Priyanka ji did, and she got justice at one level. At least the person is arrested. So that is one. Two, many times cases go unnoticed, they are not been reported in the media, and that creates a problem. So like online one. One more case I would like to give is where you see these nuns selling the children's, which is also a heinous crime like this online. So you just saw that in Jharkhand, the charity of missionaries, the sister in charge,
that's
sold four kids.
Come, yeah,
so I think, you know, that should also be discussed. And here we all,
what
as political party or
society.
What
does that have to do with the abuse? What,
no, this is, because
what
this
is missionaries'
of,
is
I'm
charity?
You, this is entirely the society which is going in what direction?
No.
So here
I'm telling you the connection here.
Here, this individual may be a person who has an hate background. He may be compulsion. There may be an OCD behind him. It may not be purely philosophical. We may say, I don't know what is his education level, what is his background.
Hmm.
But in the case of
but there
nuns,
is a context in which he
yeah, but in
threatens
the case of
rape,
nuns,
is it?
They were educated.
Is there a context
they were,
in which he threatens
they were
rape?
High profile. They knew what they were doing. So there, you know, where is the society going?
This guy did not know what he was doing when he was threatening her daughter with rape.
He's a criminal. He's a criminal when he said this, whether he's educated or not.
What does
I'm
that
trying
mean?
To say is,
what
in the case of the
any?
Minority girl who was trying to defend herself
let us
in
talk
INC
about
office
this case.
Or the
let,
nuns,
let
both were
talk.
Educated. And there they were powerful people. There Divya Swandana ji could have taken the case to police station. Rahul ji could have taken the case to police and let it investigate. In the case of nun, MSN.
I don't understand the why other case. What other cases have to do with this case?
No. When you talk about society, he pointed out that there is a societal impact, whether it is online or offline. So we all have to have patience to hear that this is happening with the society. There is a need of education of the society. And not only to the youths of the people who are educated or uneducated, but also to these pesters and nuns.
I can show you 100 educated people on my Twitter timeline and the filthy language they use against me.
They should
me.
Be booked. You should
including
file them, and we should immediately
book
them.
Served so in the
be
military.
It be the nuns
what
who sell the children.
So
whether
why
it is the nuns who the charity or it is
you're
the tormentor who
is
sitting inside the IT cell
of
Congress.
Is this guy a member of the BJP
or should be booked.
Is this guy a member of the BJP?
How does it make difference? That police will decide.
Yes or no?
I have never seen
know?
It. No, why are you trying
it?
To say that he is from the... Have you
so
investigated?
So I'm just asking you.
If you're asking me, the answer is no.
Okay,
and let the
great.
Police do their
so
job. Why are we trying
that
to...
Is
why are we
to
trying
hear.
To lead the investigation?
No, so
in
why
the, but
are
in the
you talking about everything else
minority girl
this?
Who was tormented in the Congress, it's a
case
which is serious, which we are not trying to discuss. We are not trying to discuss
the
bleak issues.
Because we're not here to discuss the minority girl. We're here to discuss...
Here she has already got justice. Let us also talk where the children have been sold by...
Let's see what happens. She's lucky she got... The guy got arrested at least. But let me just turn the attention to what's been happening on WhatsApp. Gen Z, let me bring you in over here, because there's a huge concern right now. You can see the government is reacting. It's telling WhatsApp, you know, you need to get your act together. WhatsApp is saying, yes, we're trying to bring in some features to deal with this problem. But is it easier said than done? I mean, how do you really control what goes on out on a platform like WhatsApp where some 200 million Indians who are on it right now? Gen Z?
Yeah, roughly about 200, more than 200 million people, yeah.
So how is this going to work? How are you going to regulate WhatsApp?
So, you know, that's the question that everyone is battling. And I like the optics of how this has been playing out. The government coming out and saying that, you know, that they have given a warning to WhatsApp. Managing to come out with immediately a statement which is saying that, you know, the corporates and individuals also need to, society needs to take, cognizance of this about what is happening. And the fact, you know, that in between this conversation where we don't understand what the government is trying to say, wanting to win a PR, fight that is happening here, or what the company wants to say that what they want to do on the platform itself in terms of fact checking. But let's also remember one thing, that this is a deadly ecosystem that political parties have also contributed to and have created over a long period of time. Now, some people have asked me this question, since we track WhatsApp on a very close basis and we have a helpline also where we receive these kind of messages, that did this start over the last 1 year? Only when there have been fatal consequences of this, where mob lynchings have happened and around 23 people, according to our own research, 23 people have lost their lives, is everyone talking about the platform. But let's remember that technology can be used in multiple ways, and over the last 6, 7, 8 years, all these platforms are being used by political parties, various community groups. They've been using this to polarize people, to put out the kind of various messages they are putting out. And it's only when people have started dying in this country has this conversation started. So it's something that everyone has to introspect.